Good morning to all of you friends. We are discussing all legal topics in my YouTube channel Legal Matters by Sankara Sai Babu. I request you to subscribe the same and know the legal updates as well as the decisions and judgments of the different courts of India. Our today's topic is judicial review. So this is very initially while we are discussing the constitution, you are apprised about the judicial review, and also you are made known clearly regarding Article 13 of the Constitution of India about the doctrine of severability, doctrine of separation, and doctrine of eclipse. So to be frank, to be precise, we can say that the acts which were made before the Constitution and which were not inconsistent with the Constitution, they will have the doctrine of severability and also doctrine of eclipse. Of course, if both of them, the Constitution and these acts, are in consonance, then they will continue. There only the power to review such things has come to the High Court and Supreme Courts. Please remember, judicial review is a process. It is a judicial process where the High Court and Supreme Court will judge whether any law, any amendment, any ordinance, any order passed by the executive is in consonance with the Constitution, is according to the Constitution or not. If it is against to the Constitution, it will be declared ultra vires, null and void, or it will strike down the same. This is the power of judicial review. So you know, regarding the review, I am sure you know that in CRPC, we'll be coming across section 394, 395, right, revision, review, all these things, the reference will come, you know, that is the lower courts. And also in CPC, while discussing sections 113, 114, 115, they deal with the review. Please remember, review means instead of going for the appeal, once again requesting the court to look into, to have a relook into the issue. Now, judicial review, please remember here, it is the power given to the Supreme Court under Article 32 and to the High Courts under Article 226 of the Constitution of India. So this concept emanated from the United States of America in a very famous case, the first of its case, the celebrated case, the very popular case, that is Marbury versus Madison, 1803. So you are all aware that American Constitution, the main framer or the drafters of the Constitution is James Madison as well as Thomas Jefferson. And during 1801, Thomas Jefferson, he was elected as the President of USA. Right now, we will go into the details of the case, what transpired, how the judicial review has come instance, how the judge has reviewed the situation, all the things we'll come to know. We are discussing only this case because every time we will be telling you in the famous case of Marbury versus Madison, but I think most of you do not know the contents or the brief facts of the case. Therefore, since I have a little knowledge about the legal history of the USA, since I have gone through the famous judgments like this one, Brown versus Board of Topeka and Plessy versus Ferguson, they're all celebrated judgments. I wanted to enlighten on this particular case. So now the case is Marbury versus Madison. So three persons will come into this case. Please, better you remember their names. Now, first one is Marbury. Marbury, he was elected or nominated as a judge to the court in Maryland of Virginia State. Of course, Maryland is located nearer to Washington, D.C. Right? So then Madison, you may be knowing Marbury versus Madison, James Madison. He was the Secretary of the State, that means just like our Home Minister of USA when Mr. Thomas Jefferson was the President. And Marshall, this name, my name also you have to remember. Marshall is the Chief Justice of the United States of America, and Marshall worked as Secretary of State under Adams, who is the predecessor to Thomas Jefferson. This is the brief introduction. Now we will go to the details of the case. Right? So Thomas Jefferson won the elections and he has to take charge as the President of USA. Before him, Mr. Adams. Of course, it's a lame duck government. And before giving the charge, Mr. Adams, he has given some appointments haphazardly, willfully to the, he has given commissions. They call orders called as commissions. They gave commissions to so many judiciary, so many judges. So one of them is Mr. Marbury. He was actually Adams, he has signed the commission, that means he has put his signature on the order, he has put his signature, but of course he has to leave his office, demitter office, Mr. Thomas Jefferson took over. Then Thomas Jefferson, actually the idea of Adams is to fill the posts with his people, that means with his party people, Republican people, so that they may cause embarrassment to Thomas Jefferson in his newly elected government. That is the idea behind Adams. Of course, Thomas Jefferson, he came to know the same and he wanted to withdraw all the postings. Anyway, since it was an order, executive powers of the USA president are very heavily, they are very much, they have to be respected. Anyway, he has asked the Secretary of State, Mr. Madison, not to hand over the order to Marbury. Here, please remember, Marbury was appointed, it was signed by Adams, but now the Secretary of State, Mr. Madison, he did not hand over the order to Marbury. Right? Now Jefferson took over, but Marbury once again approached him, no use. Ultimately, he approached the court of law, saying that even though the commission was signed by Adams, it was not being handed over him. Therefore, his fundamental right is violated, and therefore he is requesting to issue a writ of mandamus authority. So appoint him as a so-and-so, that is writ of mandamus. Now the matter came to the court. Please remember James Marshall. He is the Chief Justice, but it is all in America, there are political postings, but please remember, once they come to power, once they assume charge, they are totally independent, they are not biased. That is what we expect, this is what can be expected from them. Right, anyway, when the matter came up, Marshall also thought twice, thrice over the issue, whether to issue the writ of mandamus or not. No doubt, even though he issues the writ of mandamus, nobody cares. Thomas Jefferson took it and threw it in the dustbin. But how to pass the order? Then he thought of this matter, review. So then he thought of review. He issued, he framed the charges. So the charges are like this. Whether the commission was assigned by Adams or not. Number two. If so, if it is ordered, whether it the Secretary of State has to hand over the commission to Marbury or not. If so, if he did not hand over, then what is the remedial mechanism? So all these points, they have framed the issues. So arguments, heated arguments were conducted in the court. And of course, on behalf of Mr. Marbury, that is the plaintiff, the retired Supreme Court Attorney General, he argued on behalf of Marbury. Ultimately, their prayer is that when once it is signed, the commission was signed by the authority, none but the President of USA, it has to be accepted. The Secretary of State, that is Madison, is only a postmaster. He has to do the job of a postmaster. Simply, he has to deliver to the concern, which he did not do. Therefore, it is a violation of the fundamental right, or the right to occupy the coveted office of the judge, right, in Maryland. But here, there is another point also there. I want to tell about the recusal. Nowadays, we are saying the judges will recuse from the cases basing on different grounds. Of course, they need not tell the grounds on which they are recusing. But normally, they recuse the cases where the person is known to him, or he as a lawyer, this judge has appeared on his behalf, or some of his relatives are known to him, all these things in such cases. If there is any connection, according to the principles of natural justice, they recuse. Here, since the Chief Justice Marshall worked as Secretary General, Secretary of State to the USA at the time of the then President, then normally there were questions from the legal corners that he has to vacate the office. But of course, at that time, only the recusal was basing on the financial connections. If he is a director in a company of the accused, all these things, if he has got any financial connections, then only he will be recused. Therefore, John Marshall stood to the case and he conducted trial of the case. And ultimately, the basic issues are, did Marbury have a right to the commission? That means, if he did, has it been violated or not? If so, would the writ be? Okay, anyway, so definitely Chief Justice Marshall recognized that he had a perfect case. Yes, to expound the basic principle of judicial review. No doubt, the court cannot keep quiet basing on the orders given by the executive authority. If it is in consonance with the Constitution, it will be allowed. Otherwise, it will be found ultra vires. Therefore, the Supreme Court, so after castigating Jefferson and Madison also for sporting away the vested rights of the others, then the decision came against Jefferson and the Maryland. Of course, 1 year or 1.5 years period of this time is also over. But still, they asked him, Marbury, to go and take charge. So this is the greatness of judicial review. This is the first case. It is the doctrine of judicial review or principle of judicial review. So here it is clear that the Supreme Court is the arbiter of the Constitution. It is the protector of the fundamental rights. So it will review the cases where the orders of the executive, where any law made by the executive, where any amendment made by the executive, where any ordinance given by the executive, if it is against to the Constitution, they will declare it as ultra vires. So please remember, friends, sometimes the Supreme Court can review its own cases. Judicial review extends to the cases of the Supreme Court also. Supreme Court can review its own cases. Now, some of the students have got it out. Whether the judicial review is the absolute power to the Supreme Court or not, I can say yes, it has got the absolute power. Otherwise, what happens is the executive, basing on their political tantrums, they will be going for so many ordinances, so many laws, which are not inconsistent with the so-called Constitution. Definitely, the Supreme Court has the power. So in India, so let us discuss the basic rule, basic structure doctrine. So judicial review is a part of the basic structure. Therefore, it cannot be withdrawn. It cannot be abrogated. So you may be remembering very famous cases like Keshavananda Bharati versus State of Kerala, 1973, and I.R. Kohelo versus State of Tamil Nadu, 2007. These two cases are definitely very best cases for the process of judicial review. So friends, so this is the origin of the judicial review. That's why I am concentrating only on this case, that is Marbury versus Madison. So 1803, very celebrated case. Please, if at all you find time, go through the brief facts of the case. so that you will be enriched with the legal knowledge and you know what is the concept of the judicial review, why there should be a review, view, once again view, that is what is called review. So very good case, please if you have time, once again you go through the judgment. Thank you very much.